everybody. I'm pretty excited to be here with Blessing and Catherine. The State Department just brought us together as I was coming in for an interview. Yeah, it's pretty awesome. And since we're talking this week about barriers coming down, the Berlin Wall falling, commemorating that, we just stepped down to have a conversation about what kind of barriers we're facing, different barriers as women, as people with disabilities, different religions, backgrounds. So I just wanted to hear from both Catherine and Blessing about what brought them to the State Department and how they're following their dreams. So Blessing, what brought you to the DOS?
Well, I'll say for myself, I'm studying at American University. I'm studying international relations. And what brought me to the State Department is I wanted to bring more diversity to the State Department. I really wanted to be that factor in helping the State Department reflect how our country looks like. And especially in DRL, in Democracy, Human Rights, and Labor, there are so many different programs. There's disability rights, there's LGBTQ programs, and I feel as though that's really diverse and inclusive of our country. So I think that's what specifically brought me to State Department and to BRL, because I wanted to add my own part and story in making sure that State Department is reflective of all people.
Yeah, so bringing the entire community that is the United States to be part of the U.S. as well. Oh, that's so inspiring. Thank you. I'm encouraged now that that is what the U.S. is like.
Yeah.
And we'll be like more without generations.
Yeah,
thank you so much. I'm glad you're here.
Thanks.
And Catherine, what was it like for you? You know, what were you thinking about plans for the DOS?
So I go to school in Dallas, Texas at Southern Methodist University, and I'm studying human rights and history. And so I'm a senior, I'm about to graduate, and I honestly didn't really know what my next step was going to be. So applying for the State Department to work within the Department of Democracy, Human Rights, and Labor, I kind of just wanted to find a way to take all the stuff that I've been learning in school and actually see people implementing things like this. And so through my experience, I've learned so much, and I've been working a lot with the business and human rights team, which is something I had no prior knowledge about. And that's just one example of things that I've learned since I've been here. And so I really just wanted to broaden my worldview, and I'm really excited to go back to school and finish up my last semester and share everything I've learned with people in Texas.
Yeah, I'm so glad that we all went forward and that we're now here. I mean, I came from Germany with Fulbright. It's been a long journey. It's been a blessed journey, but it's been a long and difficult journey, particularly with everything it comes with, you know, having a wheelchair and all these barriers. And so I know we all have that experience when we have a dream, we have an ambition of what we want to do, make a difference in the world. We all do, right? We all really want to make a difference. And so as we go forward, I sometimes think, you know, although I'm raised to overcome that, to, you know, aim high, sometimes people don't understand the kind of barriers that we're really facing. As women, as people in the future. What would you think, would you say to people like us who are watching right now to convey these barriers and to still move forward so that more and more people can be more included in that, I'd say, struggle, in that innovative process to bring down barriers? What's your advice?
I would say finding a support system on, like, believing in yourself. That's really hard to do, but if you find something that you're passionate about and then you surround yourself by people who support you in that, I really think that's the first step into creating a more inclusive world. And
yeah, absolutely. No, I agree. Find your team, build your team, and raise your passion. And Blessing, what would you say to someone who's not sure how to pursue their dream, and more importantly, how to explain that barrier that they're facing to somebody who doesn't know?
I would say that to remember that you always belong, and especially in terms of like Department of State or in anything that you're wanting to do, just remembering that you belong and you have a voice and you should be represented in any space that you're in. So always just keeping that in mind for whatever you want to go for, whether it's in the arts or government or just any path that you want to follow, just remembering that you have a right to be there and that you need to be represented. So just always go for it. Even if you aren't sure, you'll know it's the right path or anything, just go for it and see what happens.
Yeah, Yeah, belonging. I think that's really important. My personal experience is we all really want to belong. We all really want to be part of a community. But we are really dependent on others too, you know, as much as I might build myself up. I think we all need the other person, even strangers, to recognize that we want to belong and what matters to us, what makes us us and unique and valuable. So I'm really happy you sat down to talk with me about this. It's been wonderful to meet you. Everybody who's watching, take courage, but also, you know, reach out a hand to a person that's a stranger to you now and is going to be a friend tomorrow, just like we are now.
Yes.
No, thank you, everybody.